My dear brothers and sisters, in this Eucharistic celebration, the Lord assures us that He always defends us, that He always protects us. And today, Jesus also asks us if we are willing also to defend our relationship and connection with God. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his apostles, "Behold, I am sending you like sheep in the midst of wolves, so be shrewd as serpents and simple as doves. But beware of men, for they will hand you over to courts and scourge you in their synagogues, and you will be led before governors and kings for my sake as a witness before them and the pagans. When they hand you over, do not worry about how you are to speak or what you are to say. You will be given at that moment what you are to say, for it will not be you who speak, but the Spirit of your Father speaking through you. Brother will hand over brother to death, and the father his child. Children will rise up against parents and have them put to death. You will be hated by all because of my name, but whoever endures to the end will be saved. When they persecute you in one town, flee to another. Amen, I say to you, you will not finish the towns of Israel before the Son of Man comes." Brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
As I was preparing for Mass this morning, I tried to open up the live feed of our Mass while we are on standby, and upon opening the Facebook Live of the Manila Cathedral, I already saw many of you who are already waiting for the Mass, even 15 minutes before our 7:30 Mass, and many of you are already greeting everyone, "Good morning." So I tried to comment also "Good morning" to everyone, because I thought it was really a beautiful way to start our morning. Even if we are not together physically, I can feel how you are sincerely greeting me and everyone in this page, "Good morning." So I really felt how you are greeting one another a very good morning. So good morning to everyone. And I hope that this morning and this whole day will really become a very beautiful and blessed day in the Lord. And this morning, as we start this day by celebrating this Eucharist together online, we are reminded by our readings today, first in our first reading, of the beautiful truth that God always defends us. Ang Panginoon ay laging nasa panig natin. Ang Panginoon ay laging pinagtatanggol tayo. Today in our first reading from the book of the prophet Hosea, maybe in the past days, we have heard how God tells us how Israel, how Ephraim have been unfaithful to Him. He was a good father to his children, to the children of Israel. But in spite of God being a good parent to them, they continued to be disobedient, unfaithful to the good father. That is the story of Israel as related in the book of the prophet Hosea. But now, in our first reading today, this Friday, in a way, God defends His disobedient children. He says in our first reading that He will still forgive their iniquity. They will still receive the goodness of the Father. I will listen to them if they turn back to me again. I will give them again the land of Israel. I will give them all the blessings that I would have given them. That is how God defended Israel. Kahit na ang bayang Israel ay binigyan ng Panginoon ng kabutihan, tumalikod sila sa Diyos, ang Diyos pa rin ang nagtatanggol sa kanila sapagkat ang Diyos ay nananatiling mapagmahal, nananatiling tapat sa kanyang pangako. Kaya sa umagang ito ay napakagandang paalala po sa bawat isa sa atin mula sa ating unang pagbasa na ang ating Panginoong Diyos ay patuloy na magtatanggol sa atin. Ang Panginoong Diyos ay nananatiling tapat sa atin, nakatindig sa tabi natin upang tayo ay ipagtanggol, upang tayo ay patuloy na mahalin at biyayaan. But now, in our gospel passage, it is as if Jesus is now turning the question to us. If God always stood by your side, if God always defended you, even if you are doing wrong, even if you have committed failures and mistakes in your life, God was standing by you. Now, the question of Jesus to His apostles is, will you also stand for God? If God has always been by your side, defended you, loved you, even if you have committed mistakes in your life, will you also be willing to stand by God? Will you also defend God? Will you also be faithful to God? I think this is a beautiful juxtaposition of two readings today. In the first reading, we are assured that in history, in our life, God stood by us and defended us. And now the gospel asks us, will you also stand by God? Will you also defend God? Kung sa unang pagbasa ay sinasabi sa atin, ang Panginoon ay laging nariyan para sa iyo, ang Panginoon ay hindi ka iniwan, ang Panginoon ay ipinagtanggol ka, ang tanong naman ni Jesus ngayon sa Ebanghelyo sa iyo, ikaw ba kaya mo ring tumayo at manindigan para sa Diyos? Kaya mo rin bang ipagtanggol ang Diyos? Kaya mo rin bang manindigan para sa Diyos? In the celebration of the Holy Eucharist, we always see there the cross, the suffering of Jesus on the cross. We commemorate in the Eucharist when Jesus tells us again, this is my body given for you, this is my blood offered for you. We remember how Jesus stood by us, defended us by dying on the cross. Hindi tumakbo si Jesus. Hindi niya iniwasan ng krus. Kahit humarap siya sa pagpapahirap, sa kamatayan, sa pag-uusig, sa krus nakita natin ang sabi ni Jesus, kaya kong manindigan para sa inyo. Ang tanong ni Jesus sa kanyang mga alagad, you will be facing kings, courts. you will be persecuted in my name. There will be wolves who will be hunting you like sheep. But are you also willing to defend Jesus? Are you willing to stand up for the truth? Are you willing to forsake your personal interest for the interest of the thousands of people who need you? Kung ang Diyos ay nanindigan para sa atin, sana tayo rin handang manindigan para sa katotohanan at kabutihan na nagmumula sa Diyos. I would like to address this homily to our leaders of the nation, especially those who are working in Congress, our representatives, the congressmen, our honorable, respectable congressmen. I hope whatever vote you will be doing in Congress, in the different issues, Jesus asks you today, are you willing to stand for the truth? Are you willing to defend Jesus? If God has been in your side in the moments, in the difficult moments of your life, now God asks you, ikaw naman, kaya mo bang ipagtanggol at manindigan para sa kabutihan ng nakararami at para sa katotohanan na nagmumula sa Diyos? My dear brothers and sisters, God is always on our side. He never leaves our side. Even if we have committed mistakes, even if we have failures in life, kahit nadadapa tayo, nariyan ng Diyos, hindi iniiwan tayo sa isang tabi lamang. Ngayon naman, panahon na para tayo naman ang magtanggol at maging tapat sa Diyos at kay Jesus. Amen. Let us now invoke the maternal protection of Our Lady. Remember, O most gracious Virgin Mary, that never was it known that anyone who fled to your protection, implored your help, or sought your intercession was left unaided. Inspired by this confidence, I fly unto you, O Virgin of Virgins, my Mother. To you do I come, before you I stand, sinful and sorrowful. O Mother of the Word Incarnate, despise not my petitions, but in your mercy, hear and answer me. Amen. Amen.